Yes. Farm. Farm. Anyway. Hello, everyone. This is Foxhall. Yes. I'm actually playing something. So, some of my other games, I was having some trouble streaming while recording. And some other games, well, I just didn't have time to play anything and record. A thief? Let's pause for a bit. So, where is that thief? The heck? Are you just coming to steal this one piece of jerky? Seriously? Anyway, so we have a tiny little village, yay! But this is my single player game, so I didn't want to show it too much. Or really play it, really. So, all of these buildings, I actually designed and had to build. So let's make it a little bit transparent so you can see inside. So yeah, so I designed like these buildings and had them get built. This building in here was for food, right here, with all the tables in the back, which looks very nice. I don't know why it's somewhat laggy. I guess so much going on the map. So, and then I actually went ahead and moved all these berry bushes over here so that I can easily harvest them. I actually designed the layout of the farm. And these buildings, yeah, I too designed these and put them together, even though they pile horrible. But yeah, this was just me getting like familiar with the game. I also went ahead and designed this little bridge scaffolding thing. I thought it looked cool. That's why it's Lakeville, because they all live at a lake and on the lake. That was the idea. Then I saw Bill putting houses on the land, and I'm like, well, Lakeville's now ruined, because it's no longer Lakeville. But eh, they can still be Lakeville, I guess. So anyway, so this is Stonehearth, and the main thing about this game is it's a survival game. You survive. What a surprise. And there's tiny little cute animals like this, a tiny little raccoon that cut down its home. And everything. So, what's the point? What's the goal? What are you trying to achieve? Well, surviving, of course, survival game. But there are actually like quests in the game. They're supposed to do like quest for township. So, it makes it feel like there will be an end to it. So that's why, I'm like, ooh, something to play. And over here are like some hostels. I know stuff happens when you beat them, and so this is technically an end game. Technically for that too. So as you can see, I sort of made a wall. Yeah, that kind of made things easier. A lot easier. Because I've never seen anyone trying to break down this door. Ever. So which is nice. Now, it took a while to get to this point. It honestly did. So I wanted to at least help new people out and show them how to get to, like, this point. But let's say that you're playing however you like, so let me get to a nice fresh start so we can all get to here at the same time. Now how do I back out again? That's why you escape. Alright, let's go back to the main menu. How about I just take a quick cut here? Alright, so on the main menu, you see my current save that I had. That's the last game I had loaded up. Let's turn down the music a bit. So, let's start a new game. And so this is it right here. This is how you start the game. So, I still feel it's a little bit loud, but oh well. So we have the Ascendry, and then we got Reyes Children. Pretty much think of it as like the typical like European guys and the what looks like airbenders, pretty much. So I guess like India, not India. Think of it like they have clay houses. Those guys. I don't know what good example to put, but whatever. So we're gonna do the typical easy stock guys. So next tells you a little bit about them too. So temperate or desert. So obviously these guys, the normal European guys, are normal for temperate. You don't want to do desert with them. Then it's the complete opposite with the other guys. You want to do desert for the other guys. But I have never played them, so I'm not too sure of the difficulties and ease of either or for either or level. Even tells you that these are good for like Rayestron. These are good for Ascendry. So, just because I'm showing the game out, let's just do that. And, you know, do you want to just be a sandbox or you just do what the heck you want? Or do you want to make it harder on yourself with monsters? I don't want to make it too hard. Let's do normal. And this picture keeps updating, which is nice. So now we get to the next part, which is going to be somewhat essential for a new player. You get 7 characters, and you can actually change what they start with, kinda. So if you don't like someone in particular, like let's say I really don't want a cultist in the group. Well, you have this reroll button right here. You can either do that or you can reroll everybody. Let's just reroll everyone right now. So now you see everyone has new stats, new features, new looks. So let's go ahead and be like, I really don't want this glutton. So you can just reroll just that guy. Simple. I actually want to keep him. I don't want anyone that just eats meat. You don't have enough high stats for me to really enjoy you. You have a pet. The fox saved their hurtling from mortal danger. Nah. I don't want to do any pets. It just will complicate things. Courageous. Alright. Let's keep you. It'd be nice having someone who's courageous, I think. So I don't want anyone who's depressed. A jokester. Heart of a crafter, eh? But you really stink at thinking. You really like crafting, but you're a terrible person. Yeah, so that's something to talk about. Mind, body, spirit, you know. So you gotta think of it like this is, the game tells you right there when you hover over it, tells you what each thing is. So you can get a good idea what you want for each person. Because you want someone to fight, you want someone that can invent, create items, and you want someone who wants to do like, I guess all the other like other stuff, which is kind of like spirit. Healing, compassion stuff like taming animals. So you have everything you need for this game at least. I think just keeping him at 3 for everything, that's good enough. Let's see. You can technically get someone with 666, like perfect across the board, or nearly perfect, like 555, but I'm not going to spend that much time into it. Keep re-rolling them forever. So, Callus. But their constant guard of composure makes them slow to make friends. Oh, that's nice. I don't want to keep that, I think. Let's have you be the healer or something. Passionate Trapper. Ooh. We'll think about that. No. Let's think about no. Ooh. Yeah, let's keep you. Alright, so then we want change you. No, keep you alone. Want someone with high body and high spirit. Because high body is for high body is pretty much like there we go. So muscle, speed, stamina, it's pretty much everything they need to fight with. So then you can think of mind. It says right there diligence. So diligence is how often like they're lazy or how quickly they wake up. So for a fighter, I think diligence is not as important. It can be, but not really. And then for spirit, it pretty much says that right there, courage. So that's why I want someone with high body and high spirit. And let's see. I want someone who's depressed. Yeah, I'm just gonna do this for a little bit, see what we get. Actually, let's keep going until we see someone who's a passionate fighter. Oh, I just passed it. Darn it. And the next passionate fighter, not someone who's good at fighting, but or courageous. I just want to see who's a passionate fighter. What the heck is this? Passionate archer? Sure, why not? It's good enough. So you get the idea. So, and then here you see, how do you want to start the game? So, this actually determines your starting stuff. So, you can make it easier on yourself or harder on yourself based on what you pick. Honestly, I usually like going for food for days. This way I can just really concentrate on making a house right off the bat. But you really don't have to. At all. And you still have some basic starting supplies. Like, it says nothing here about a saw, but you start with a saw. So you can still make a crafter. And right off the bat, a crafter can make a farming tool. So, let's start with the merchant caravan, because I have never done this before. And right now, this main goal of the first episode, it's just to show it off a little bit and to get things rolling. So, and I may or may not continue it just because, like, I don't think anyone cares or even wants to watch this. So, we'll see what happens. If people really demand for me to play this, I will be playing it more. So, there's two things how you could do this. What I have done in my past, so the square, the highlighted the square, is where is your map, pretty much. That determines your map. Everything that's dark is not your map. That will not be in the game. So, with this world seed, this is what we have. Now we have to pick an area. So what I have done in the past is, you see this island down here? I have started games on the island. On islands in general, and enemies can't get to me because they'll usually start in like the areas that's unexplored, which is going to be outside of the island, and there's no way they can get to me. Usually on like a single bridge is the only way for them to get to me, and it's pretty much an easy one because then you can focus all your strength in one area. But at the same time, is it really a guaranteed victory? Because you still have to fight, and your people could fail. So, there's that to think about. So let's re-roll and see what else we get. Just show you the potential and how different maps are. They do plan on adding biomes. I did see that. So even though there's no special biomes right now, I did see that they're planning on making biomes. I want a little bit more water.
I want like one entire half of the map just water. I think that would be kind of cool. Like down here, I can do like some bit of the map water, but I don't want to start in the mountains at all. Let's re-roll again. What's the one thing I would like to see is some water in the center of the map, so I can actually plan around that a little bit easier. Like this one. Look, water in the center of the map. Perfect. Except I don't want to start an island this time. The one time I don't want to start an island. Like, a perfect island map. Oh well. But you know what? This would actually be a nice spot for a setup. So, let's start. I want to just get right outside of that range of the island so nothing spawns on the island and I don't have to worry about it. Or we can cover it completely. Maybe the goblins will spawn there, which would be hilarious. I know. Let's just do this right here. Well, right outside the range of that. Don't worry about... The dead center is not your camp. You actually pick your camp later. Let's do it one more time. Even though this is just for show, I like to be a little bit serious about everything, after all. Oh, this is worse. Actually, no, it's not. Yeah. It's not really. Because we can easily fortify up this little area. Yeah, let's use that little area. Be kind of cool. Let's have it like that. Settle here. I specifically moved... Nah, I'm just gonna... I want to at least show the loading screen a little bit. So, I specifically had the map kind of oriented so that the map is kind of cut off by the water. So, I had some less spaces where things could spawn in from. It's just how I wanted to put the map in. Alright, so now we gotta pick where we want the actual camp to be. So, the ads are being very annoying, trying to make me click on it. Flowers up in the mountains. So, you can see how it is. We got some weird statues around, which look like bunnies. Probably is, considering we have stuff going on. So, just so we can get that out of the way, let's have them right here. Cause I like making these areas into farms, because I'm weird and crazy. Let's put you right here. The name of your settlement. Let's name this Pine Cone. No, that's a silly name. Foxville? No. Ketchup? No. That's weird. Let's see, they start with the berries. They have some girl with blue pigtails. You know what? New Haven, because why not? Alright, let's pause real quick. So now you see we have Fog of War now, all of a sudden. Even though it's not, because we can still things moving around. I don't really see anything right now, but yeah, you can still see animals and stuff walking around. So it's not really fog of war. So the big thing here is we need to secure food. As you see right here, we have some food, but not enough food. So you can see we actually started with some tools on the ground, and they kind of sparkle, which is nice. So they're pretty obvious. So we have a trapper's knife, a wooden sword so we can defend Swarf the Bat, and a herbalist staff. So let's go down and pick somebody. We're gonna have to make somebody into a trapper at the bat. So let's have you, because you actually want to be someone who's important someday. Let's have you be the trapper right off the bat. Because it makes sense. So, it's okay to have your main military guy start off a different class early on. Because each time, right now as workers, they don't gain levels. See, no level up right there. However, once he becomes a trapper, Come on. We'll now see that he actually has like a level. He's level 1 now. Actually, he's progressing to level 1, so he's like level 0 right now. So, each time they level up, their health will increase. So, it doesn't matter what they get the level from, as long as they level up with anything, they'll get more health. So it's for your military, it's technically better for them to level up with different classes first before you put them into their main role as like a fighter, because this way they'll be very hardy and defensive. So how are we going to get this guy to start making us food? Well, now that we got a trapper, we can put down a trapper ground, which is a zone that from here you designate zones you want them to hut in. So let's see, where do I want you to do your hunting? Let's just say out in the open field. Is there any animals out here? I don't see any. No, we can let the game play a little bit. We should see some movements. Well, I'm not seeing anything right now, but let's just say over here in this forest will be a big zone. Oh, that's how big you can make it. I thought it was going to be bigger than that. Okay, so let's make it a little bit closer then. There's fine. Trappers will place traps in grounds and will periodically catch to see if anything has been caught. Sure. Alright, so we got a source of raw food. So I also want to put somewhere so we can actually do a stockpile of food. This way everyone can will go around and collect food, like all these berries and stuff is on the ground. Let's just do that real quick to show it off. Yeah, let's make it everything. This way they can organize. You can see how they organize. Alright, so here they go. They're going over and collecting. Well, this is how you harvest. Just an example. Easy. So you can see that now that we designated the area, they're just putting everything in this little area. And as long as you don't overwork them, they can do a lot of stuff very quickly. But once you give them a lot more tasks, it can get very chaotic. Like, if we want them to do other stuff, they can't because they're so focused on this. Because they tend to do the closest thing, but they don't tend to put stuff in storage while they still have jobs. Which is kind of weird to say. Like, you can give them a lot of jobs, and they'll keep doing the jobs. But if you want them to move stuff from here, they don't usually prioritize that. if there were open jobs. Like right now, all the jobs are being filled, so that's why she went ahead and put the flower in here. Are you gonna be a dummy? Please be a dummy. So right now I'm just going around collecting all the stone, because I think the stone would be important for later on. So, do we start with a saw? Yeah, we did start with a saw, like I said. Well, that's where you don't have no one to actually build yet. So let's take a moment and see. So high mind equals a good worker, pretty much, like this person. She would be a perfect person. But we don't need her to be one right away because... Because she'd be happier even though she's a crafter and crafting things. But I also want to level up somebody who will be a fighter someday. Like this guy. He's actually going to fight. So let's have him craft. Because he'll level up usually very quickly with that. And we can have someone... we don't have to worry about defending just yet. We got no monsters. So why worry about it? So this is important. Let's... to stop making things very early. Instead of just going around and collecting a whole bunch of stuff. You should be making stuff early on. Because... you need food, you need stuff, but most importantly, you need the people to live somewhere. This is a town after all, a settlement. People need houses, people need beds. And he needs a way to make those beds. So, that's how we went ahead and put this anvil down here. That's how we got into making him able to create stuff off the bat. So, he's gonna go over, grab the supplies he needs. Usually, as long as you keep getting a little bit of everything, you don't need to make sure you have the proper stuff. What are you doing? All things considered, I'm doing okay, but what are you doing? How do you see what you're doing? Oh, in here. So, I can see that he's restocking items because he has no other job. He's gonna go and move stuff around. Which is normal. Normal. So, let's say... I don't want you to do that. I want you... to do more crafting. But I can't do more crafting because it will say down here... that he requires a workbench. Well, we just made him a workbench, but... thing is, it's in storage. And it's sparkly, which means we haven't placed it yet. We need to actually put it somewhere. So you need to go to the house icon, you need to do place item. So now we can place it somewhere. It doesn't matter where you place it very early on because if you're someone like me, you're going to actually have an actual house for him. The crafter's house. This way he can craft things. So by default, the crafting house will be the copper's house. So... that's where the copper will live, that's where all his stuff will be. I'm not a typical person that will actually use the default houses. I like to make my own stuff. So, let's look at that in a bit. Let's have him start by making enough beds for everybody. So, a grizzled traveler arrives. Just celebrate your embrocation day, eh? Buck up, you look like you really benefit from some tasty... something tasty. How about I give you 2 rabbit jerky? Thank you. That's very nice of them. And then they'll go over, pick it up, and move it into storage. Which is nice. Alright, already you can see our storage is getting full, so let's go ahead and make another one. Let's say this is only for construction and goods. Then we can go into this other one we have, and we can say, I don't want construction goods in that. So they'll actually organize it a bit. And actually free up space. So that's one way you can organize. Right now I just did it mostly to show you how you can do that.
I usually always do it. I always organize. The carpenter had already leveled up. Yeah, excellent. As soon as he gets to max level, I'm just gonna shove him to the other job. As a fighter. Because I don't really care about him being like all powerful. I just want him to get some starting bonus. He doesn't need to be like amazing. Why are you just standing up here? Don't, stop being weird. So now we should have him be... start working on a building. So one thing you should note, the reason why I don't want any fighters right now, you see how many workers we have? All these people will haul, build, mine, and do jobs. You see the trapper? We can't click on the build and mine, but we can for everyone else. Because workers are workers. A trapper is not a worker. So why would a trapper want to build and mine? That's not his job. He will do his jobs. So we need to make sure we have enough people to do jobs to stop up with, because we have no houses. So that's why I'm like, we don't need a military right now. We just need homes. So you can do the standard houses, which is this button, or you can design. That's what I like to do. So you always need to start with the foundation. You don't have to. You can just do a random wall. But then at that point, it's like, why? Why? Because you won't be able to add the walls and the roof and won't look like a house. Because you can do this how you want. You can just do a floor and put just freaking beds on it if you really want. So, let's see. Where do I want this? Alright, I want this in the dead center over here, I think. Yes. I do. Let's say we want, like, not that huge. I want it enough where everyone can live. I don't want an odd number. I want an even number, so I can put a door in the dead center. Like that. Let's just see what it looks like with... Yeah, that'll be nice. Let's put some of the beds in here. So we know how it's gonna be. So there's a little faint arrow. I don't know if you can see it, but I tried zooming in a bit. That's much easier to see on this dirt other than this. So the arrow will show you pretty much the area it's facing. You can think of it as, like, I guess where the arrow is pointing, that will be where the feet will go, while the head will be away from it when they lay down. If you want to make sure that you put them in a spot where they will actually look like they're sleeping well, instead of having, like, someone's feet right into someone's head in a way like that. Typically, I don't like to do that. So let's have everyone kind of organized like this. And that's too close. More space between. That's fine. And so if you don't know how I'm rotating this, it's pretty much comma and period. Yeah, I learned the hallway. I was doing R like a million times and was wondering why everything was breaking. Don't use R. Use any other button other than R. Alright, so we have the beds. You know what? Let's pretend that everyone has their own little dresser. So it actually says here that this is just a decorative item. It actually tells you. But you know what? Each decorative item levels, gives us experience. And with each experience, our guy will level up more. So yeah, there's... let's move that a bit. So So the reason why I'm moving it a bit because it was like kind of blocking the center here, and I'm thinking if that's the walkway. We need f 8 because there's 8 beds here. So 1, 2, 3, 4. That doesn't look pretty good. Let's just leave it like this. It doesn't need to be perfect. Actually, I don't want it on this floor. I don't want it on that floor at all. I want that on the next floor up. So, kind of like here. If I want to change this to a different layout. Doesn't it look a lot better now? Except now we want to add stairs. That high enough? Yeah, it's just high enough. So let's make it this a little bit smaller. Where is the center? I think it's like right here. So do 4 spaces away. What the heck happened there? Whoa, that's too big. What the heck happened? Why are you doing that? That's what I want. And then what I want is make another staircase with this. But make it just slightly bigger. Move it like that. This way it'll look like there's a railing to it. And it'll be kind of nice. The only thing is now that doesn't look very good. So let's take some slabs and we'll just kind of cover this up. So just don't worry too much if you're wasting resources because, after all, you're just having fun. Let's not do that last layer because this is the foundation. So, there we go. Then I want this to be covered up again. There we go. Hey, why didn't that fill up? Rude. That looks nice. That doesn't look nice to me though. Let's just move that. There we go. Maybe we can add like a railing on the side in a bit. So now we have the basics. We need doors, don't we? There we go, a door. So, I actually have a plan to this. Why do I want a staircase? Why did I get rid of all the beds? Why do kids like never do what you say? I don't know. But the reason why I wanted this staircase here is because, hey, look, we have people staying out of our way now. What a surprise! No, we don't want that. I never actually used the slice before because I never had to because I don't do stuff underground usually. So I want this to look good. So like that, like this, like that. It's not exactly perfect. Let's do one more space away from the wall. Why isn't like equal? Weird. What if we just put it on its side? Like that. Then there's not enough room for the other beds. Oh, that's frustrating. Let's have it like this. You know what? There'll be enough for 8 on each side, so this is fine. Then we could put something in the middle, right in the middle. I just want 8 beds, just because. So this upper floor would be the dorm. This lower floor is where I want to put like food and stuff. It was why I want to put this in the center. Hey, look, this is gonna be the farm area. Do you really want the people for the farm going a million miles away? Not exactly. So then on the side, so we have a dilemma. I want people to put food down, but where? But how? I wonder how high they can access items, because I'm thinking about this. If you make a shelf, would they be able to access that from up here? Or would they have to be a little bit lower? But would they be able to put things into like storage right here at all? Like, does it have to be the same level, or can they just reach up that high? We have to test that. Not right now. I'm gonna test it on my own. I'm not gonna test it with you guys. But you get the idea. So what I like to do is put chairs like along here, along the stairs. This way, when people need to eat, they can easily take stuff and then go to a chair and sit down, because what they like to do is go to the nearest chair and eat their food in complete like solitude and don't talk or do anything with anybody else. So we're just giving them a little bit of freedom to do that. Ooh, can I put like a bench in the middle there? I might be able to. Can I just fill this entire thing up with benches? It's not like a dining room or anything. It's more or less just like a place to eat. How does that look? Looks fine. But we're gonna add the space anyway. Yeah, this is kind of perfect. I haven't tried using the benches before for like in here, but it doesn't look too bad. It looks a little bit out of place, but eh. So let's see, what do we want? The storage boxes. We want them. So you see here, this is where the arrows become important. I don't know if they can access the chest from any direction. I've always just allowed them to be able to access it from just using it like on the ground, so that's what I've been doing, and I'm gonna keep doing it that way, because I would hate to run into a situation where they're just completely unable to use all the chests. Well, in this case just crates, because they're unable to get to them. So we're doing this so that we know they're safe. We know everything's good. And we don't have to worry about them at all. So, I guess we can put stuff up against this wall. Like, why not? How do we want them to act to get into that, though? Let's have it like this. There you go. I do the tiny little space so they can still get in there. But I'm not having the arrow face this way because I don't want them going in here and just to get into this. So that should be good. We're using up our space very efficiently. So they should be able to do everything. The only problem is we don't have any light in here, do we? So it's going to be very dark when they actually do start using this place. So let's put in some wall lanterns. So I couldn't find this for the longest time, but it's apparently up here in decorations for light. Let's put one over here. No. It's going to be very difficult to decide where to put these. Actually, so this is about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is 8. So, actually, it's right behind that. Yeah, it's gonna be like that. It's kind of silly. No. No, let's not do that. Let's just put one here, one here, then go to the other side. Put one here, and put one here. That's fine. That's more than enough light for up there. But for up here... you could do it in the same spots a little bit, but... this is where people are going to be sleeping. Do we really want lights up here? No. I think we just put two of these right here. Now people have light up here. They can easily... go up and down the stairs still, so it's gonna be nice. Let's put this right here. Then I wanna put some slabs. It's like a little fake railing. It's not an actual real fence or anything, but good enough. And just to make it seem a little bit more like a staircase, we'll add that. There we go. It'll look like it adds more support. Ooh, that does look nice. Let's do these flowers, though. Hmm. Yes. And then, how big of a window can we do? That's fine. We'll add some color to the room. And make their lives not seem like depressing. I want to change these walls, I think. How does this look? So, I don't think it goes as well. I'm just trying to click off the floor so the blue outline is on everything. Maybe if we get rid of the grid, it'll look a little bit better. So, zooming out... I don't know. Let's add a roof to this before we decide. So, how do you want the roof? Because it's kind of square... I think we do a square-ish roof, like this. Yeah. How about the overhang? Overhang's good at one? Yeah. Let's kick down the roof down by one level. No. Actually, yeah, I want it down one level. It may cut down the supplies a little bit that they need. And then if you change the roof height, it'll be more pointed. So you could decide how high you want the roof. Let's just leave it like that for now. The one thing I want, though, is more windows. Because it's two windows right there, I want to do two windows on the other side. Because otherwise it'll just be tacky. Like that. But I'm doing two windows right there, I want to do two windows right here. And then two windows right over here. So how will that look inside? You know what? That works out perfectly. Because I don't want people like directly in front of the windows. But this will work out good. So let's put more flowers right here. This way everyone can smell morning flowers each day. If you had them outside, well, how are people going to take care of them? Even though they're just decoration, they don't actually take care of them. But at least it will make outside seem a little bit more clean, and the inside will be like a little bit more cluttered up. You actually do get a lot more decorations, you just have to unlock them. After all, he needs to level up. So this is good. Down here is good as well. We could add some windows. We could add windows like this. Wait, I didn't say right there. I wanted it right here. But my main thing is I like to match the windows with the second floors. So I think I will just match it with the doors for now. Because otherwise I will want to put windows like to match the second floor. And I don't want to do that right now. So, the last thing I just want to do is put some lights on the outside. One space away from the doors. This way it's nice and well lit. And easily find the doors in the future. Alright, so once you're done designing a house, for one thing, you need the house selected. Then hit finish editing. Eh, you can name it like farm dorm. You can save it. This will be added to your templates in the future. You can actually go in and like delete them, but you can't delete them from inside the game. I found you have to go into your actual folder and find it and delete it, which that's actually inside your. I forgot where exactly it was. I think it was inside the actual Steam folder. Yeah. Where Steam was. So, I just want to say 8 room. No, 8 beds. Because it's not rooms, it's beds. And this is a dorm. Where everyone sleeps together. So, yeah. That's saved. So let's build it now. So, you may say, well, you now you got to go ahead and build everything individually. The crafter needs to craft everything. But you need to tell him to craft everything, right? Because you told him to make all the beds. No. I don't. Because everything should be added to here automatically. Ta-da! And for some reason wants me to make all the beds. But you know what? We already have all the beds. So let's just move that to the bottom. I think lights are more important than that, and chairs are more important than that, and windowsills are more important, doors are more important than that, because how people can get in and out, windows are more important than that, yeah, so that's good. So you hear all this, so they're actually digging out the foundation. I didn't know there's stone in here. What is this? I can't even check. Oops. Don't ignore that. So what is that? It won't even tell me what this is. So it's gonna take a while. You can speed it up here on the side. But yeah, that's life. Oh, you're doing stuff. Did you actually find anything? Equipment, backpack. Oh, you are. Nice. I haven't used choppers before, so they're like new for me. I'm like, oh, neat. Oh, neat. When someone has time, can you move these berry bushes over here? I would really appreciate someone taking the time to get food over to our actual place. So, we have something a little bit more, reliable. I don't know how much space is to get bushes, so I usually just give them like a full bush, which is like 3 squares, 3x3. So, hey, he leveled up. I don't care. So I could harvest these, then move them, but I like to just move them first. I just want them in my area first. Because how else would we easily harvest them in the future? So far, I found no game-breaking stuff with just moving them. I have only found game-breaking stuff, but, well, not really game-breaking, just graphic glitches, I think. By having them too close together, because I'm giving them so much space. But I had harvested them, then moved them. I had moved them before harvesting. I haven't found any issues. You can move them, then harvest them like immediately. There's no issues that I've found so far. So now it's night. Everyone will want to sleep. But we have no beds. I was going to put beds outside, but I already have the house being made. They'll sleep on the floor. They don't necessarily need beds, but they get unhappy when they sleep on the ground. But everyone starts the very beginning with a little boost. Like, we'll just check one guy. Oh, I'm tired. My meal was raw. I lack safety. But they gain a huge boost to pioneering. You have 2 full days. I think that's 3 full days, maybe. Maybe. I don't know exactly. But as you can see, you have some time. You really do have some time. I want to finish moving these. See, this is the issue now that I was talking about. You give them way too many jobs. And you want them to do certain jobs now, but they can't because you just keep giving them more and more jobs, and they don't, and they're not prioritizing the jobs you want them to do. Like, I want them to do these berry bushes like now, but they're still building a house. So when are they going to get around to doing the actual berry bushes? I don't know. Looks like they're doing it now, though. Yeah, they are doing it now. They're prioritizing the moving the bushes over. What is? Oh, he broke down the bush into a little potted bush to move it, but he didn't actually take it. So let's see. You're making a lot of stuff there, dude. Which was planned. So, did I tell them all to get harvested? No, just the ones that's actually here. Interesting. So, yeah, I would say there's not enough workers, I think. Why the exclamation mark? I can't click on it or anything. I think it's just letting me know that no one's actually working on it. Let's speed this up a bit. Because everyone's gonna be hungry the next day, so we need to make sure we get, like, food quickly. Berry bushes do regrow. So we don't have to worry about going hungry forever. So that's why I'm like, let's bring the berry glitches closer. From what I've noticed, it seems like a full day, but normally I have farms to also go along it, side of it, so... Yeah, I usually have... I don't worry about food too much. Please tell me no one fell asleep out here. I really don't want someone going to sleep out here in the, like, the middle of nowhere. There we go. Does the exclamation mark go away? Oh no, they eat in the morning as well? Oh, daily update. So, you see here, we get more people for meeting requirements. So, right now, the requirements of this game is food and gold. And it will keep increasing as you get more people. But it doesn't increase until you get more people. And then, when you actually get somebody to, you know, want to come in, you have the option to accept or decline. You don't know what they are, you don't know their stats or anything, but... Yeah. Does the music slow down when... I don't know if the music for the sleeping speeds up or slow down. I don't know. Why aren't you doing anything? We have an entire house to build. Why is no one building the house? I don't know what's going on. Oh, we ran out of wood. We need more wood for it. Let's cut down all these small trees. There we go. So that was the issue. That's why there's a mark right here. And the only way I figured it out was because here it says our supply. Something of 30. The something will increase depending on how much we have. So we need more, obviously, of that something. So let's just get... So they're going to chop down all these trees. They'll get more wood, and that will fulfill the requirement that they'll need. Yeah, you leveled up to level 1. You don't stink as much at your job. It's very interesting how they do this. So, they will use wood blocks to make scaffolding. Scaffolding is important so they can actually build, but they also are very stupid at it at times. So if you ever run into a problem with they're being stupid and they left like a chunk of wood on top of the roof, you can easily make a ladder going up it so you can easily get your wood back if you care. So you don't have to worry about it too much. There is a way around it. Well, let's say they built the house and now there's no more scaffolding. So now you need to put more scaffolding in. So that would be where the ladder comes in, because they won't put a scaffolding in just to put something on the roof. I don't know if they would or not. I don't have to yet. We can do that in the future later. So I don't know how they're building this. I don't know why they prioritize the building the stairs. Like, do the frame of the place first, jeez. The stairs is pretty important, this way you can go up to the second floor and start building the frame from up there. Are you done with the staircase yet? I can't even tell. What is this? What is that you left up there? Oh, it's a ladder. It looked a little bit weird because you just kind of left it there. The reason why they're building scaffolding through the staircase is because, if you remember, we have a little wall right here. So the scaffolding is going up to where that floor would be, so they can actually go up to that floor to stop building that floor. But they're kind of stupid with scaffolding at times. And that's why they're sort of building it through objects, because they don't realize that it's there. And they can just walk upstairs. And they're wasting their time by building scaffolding up. At least they got wood. Let's have you harvest some more of this. There you go. I don't know if the guy needs it or not right now, but I'm gonna make sure he can use it. Let's speed it up. Alright, I think I'm gonna cut here and come back when they're done with the house, because you have the idea. Oh, what's this? Hello, I want you to make 8 new beds in 1 day. Might be able to make 1 stone wall. Nah. Alright, be right back. Hey, we're back. So while we were, I was waiting, we got attacked by invaders. Entlings. So everyone's still building, they're mostly done. And they put in some of the objects into the house. But right now we really need someone to defend. And our guys, let's actually see how well they do. So we're gonna tell everyone to go back home. To defend. Oh my gosh, that's a lot of them. So everyone's gonna group up together at home. Because everyone is stronger together as a big group after all. So this is without someone to defend. Let's see how well they do. So the red hearts is my team. The white hearts are the enemies. Let's see if they can win. Without any deaths. Yeah. So they can win pretty easily. Now there's a problem. There's wood here, but they won't use the wood because it's not ours. It's theirs. It's the loot. It's pretty a good way to prevent you from accidentally having guys rush out to the middle of nowhere and get killed. So, let's loot all this. There we go. Now people will come by, pick this up, and bring it back to storage. And they're mostly done. So while we were waiting, I went ahead and also, I want to carve these all together. So while we're also waiting, I made some farmer hoes. So now that we got farmer hoes, because the crafter, he could make it. He could make farmer hoes and the tools and weapons, and these only require level 2 carpenter, and he's level 3 right now. So easy peasy. And let's have him queue up this as well. Leave it at the bottom, of course, because we don't need it immediately. And we're good at everything else. Let's make a second one of the practice swords, though. So let's have him cut down some more trees as well. Here we go. We'll need it. I don't think this house is going to get done anytime soon. Well, actually, it will. And they should be able to complete with what they have. And then when they break down the scaffolding, we'll get all that supplies back. It should be good. So, as of right now, I think they're eating. Yeah, they're eating. What are you guys doing in there? Oh, so we have put down the crates. So now you see that we have... I'm looking at contents. So now we see that they're actually using the crates a bit. And that's why they're all inside the house, because someone left food in the house. Which is a good thing. It's full of jerky. Squirrel jerky. It's silly. So
Now they should be starting to put stuff on the second floor, especially when they're done building the roof and they break down the scaffolding. It looks like this individual, she likes to come by and take stuff from here and bring it to the house to fill it up. And she's a regular worker, she's no important. Fire. So, we need someone to stop farming so we have more reliable food. Because here, yeah, we have berries growing in. I'm waiting until these grow in before we harvest these, because I want to get it all at the same time. It'll be nice. So, what I mean by reliable food, I don't want to be the one to have to manually do this, because what if I forget one day? What if I'm too busy or something? So, let's pick that one guy that had the... yeah, with this. The green thumb. I don't think we have any fighters. Yeah, we don't have anyone else who wants to fight. So let's change your job. Let's have you be a farmer for life. That's your new job. You're now a farmer. Congrats. And then as soon as he becomes a farmer, the farm zone will be available. There we go. And how do you want to do this? I want... let's keep it away from the front door. And also three spaces away from the house. One, two, three. Like that. There we go. Here I want you to grow turnips. And here... move that. And here I want you to grow carrots. They both grow very quickly, so that will give him some time to, it'll give us plenty of food. Now, you don't have to worry about that as much. I made two because I like to do two early on, but for now, we have some guy making squirrel jerky every once in a while. We'll do that, we'll do this. I'm just trying to wait until he makes the... until they put in beds. Oh, see, they just became transparent. That pretty much shows you that that's the thing that they're going to be doing right now. That's their current job. If you have, like, the house selected, you can see everything, but when it's not selected, pretty much the only things you see is their current jobs. So they're currently, they want to put in beds. Who is putting in the beds? I don't see anyone going up the stairs or anything. Unless they're just like getting ready. They're projecting this is where they want to put everything. They're probably getting distracted by the berry bushes or something. Or they're putting stuff inside. So, I could change it where inside will be just food, but for now, we just need them to centralize everything. So, they don't have to run all the way back here. They can just leave everything here. I don't know why I want to put the houses yet. If I even do continue this. I'll probably upload the video first, wait a few days, see if anyone replies saying, yeah, continue this, please. Because everyone else has stopped playing this or something, and we really want to keep watching this. Oh, we just like you, we like to listen to your voice. I don't know. Give me your weird, creepy reason why you want me to keep playing this. You put any beds yet? No. You guys keep being tired, you complain that you're sleeping outside and stuff. Are you? Are you complaining that you're sleeping outside? Lack of safety, feared for my life. No, you actually don't care that you slept outside. Who are you? Lonely. There's people all around you. Why are you lonely? You're talking to someone right now. Why are you lonely? Stupid people. Yeah, no one really cares that they have been sleeping on the ground for a while. Just the dirt. Huh. Is anyone going to go ahead and actually put stuff in? You've actually put in the jobs. You haven't done it yet. Oh, come on. He's been doing nothing but tilling the ground. He hasn't actually done any work. That's why I usually wait until they finish one farm up completely before I do the second farm. This way they're not wasting time tilling. But luckily we still have plenty of food. Plenty of jerky. Alright. As soon as I see them start putting in beds, I think I'm going to make some people into warriors, finally. Whoops. So, he's level 4. He's level 2. These are the two guys I want to push on to fighters soon. But we may have to make someone else do a fighter first in the meantime. Which would be fine. It just means they would level up. And which means I can put them into more dangerous jobs. That's actually not a bad idea. So we want someone with high spirit like you. You'd be alright. Excitable. Sure. And move mountains. Yeah, let's have you be, the healer. So, I'm gonna have him be the fighter first. Even though it's like, why are you having him be a fighter first if you want him to heal? Well, he needs some experience. Otherwise, how is he gonna get more health? Do you really want a healer to have low health? Well, technically it doesn't matter because they'll be healing at a distance if he's magical. Right now. Oh, so they are doing the beds finally. Excellent. Alright, so I'm gonna call there for now. He actually started planning stuff. So let's just see what the overall house looks like. So it's decent. This is a quick little house. It's still, like, you know, kind of neat because it has some unique features to it, like a staircase. A staircase would be difficult to add in for, you know, a common person. Doing more than one floor could be difficult for people. But this is just a very simple two-story building. One where they can actually go sleep quickly, go downstairs, get food quickly, go outside, farm, then quickly bring in food. Then there'll be chairs here. They tend to go to the nearest chair to eat. So you don't want a chair the other side of the map, because then they'll walk all the way over there to just sit down to eat. So by having chairs nearby, they won't walk very far, which means they don't waste time, which means they get back to work faster. Alright, that's all I have to say for this episode. Let's just peer down and watch these guys sleep. With their dark, soreless eyes. Anyways, bye! See you guys later!